Today you can leave the Gold Coast at sunrise and glide along the dual carriage freeway almost uninterrupted and be in Sydney by mid-afternoon. But this wasn't always the case. After completing a four-day ride up from Queensland, I now need to return back home and I want to rediscover the old bypassed parts of the Pacific Highway. The Gold Coast, 4 days from Sydney, and now it's time to head back.
Maybe not technically in the right spot, but it didn't look pretty. This looks much nicer.
Can't help you there, mate.
So, I loaded the wrong file, and where did it take me? Straight onto the freeway, which is exactly where I didn't want to go. So let's try that again.
The Boyd's Bat Bridge replaced a ferry in 1934, and that original version was lifted by hand until it was replaced by this version of the bridge in 1984.
So in 1994, I finished school, finished high school, and drove from Sydney to the Gold Coast. And while I can't relive being 18, I can maybe relive that journey a little bit. Pacific Highway's obviously gone through many iterations over the years, so there's not an exact route to follow if you want to follow the old road, because it depends on the era. By the way, my speedo's out by about 15%, so if you're looking at that going, "You're speeding." I'm not actually, it's a long way out. There is a couple of choices when we get closer to Sydney. Pacific Highway at one stage went out to Pete's Ridge before they built Moonee. So there's a bunch of different variations, but I'm gonna essentially be going for what would have been around, around the 90s. I initially planned this as a 2 day, but I'm thinking it'll be 3 days. 791 k's from here, spotto, off in the distance. I actually don't have a booking, I don't have anything set as far as where I'm going to stay tonight, so just playing it by ear, or we can find something. I've never done that before, actually. I don't think I've ever done that in my entire life, not had a booking for accommodation for the night, so living wild. So adventurous. I'm on an adventure bike, I have to be adventurous, don't I? So some of these little routes I'm taking, even though technically that's probably Pacific Highway, as its nameplate now, spotto, it's not what would have been back in the day. So I'm kind of, what I've plotted out is a route that avoids, the 100k freeways and follows what most likely would have been the road back in the day. However, even though I took that little detour just to show, I do need to take the freeway in this case to get to the other side of where I need to be.
Well, look at that. I did actually plan to stop here. At the end of 1996, the Chinderah bypass was completed, which included a replacement of the Barney's Point Bridge. You can see parts of the old bridge still here on the western side. From Chinderah, we're following the Tweed River to Marillimba, which was renamed from Pacific Highway to Tweed Valley Way.
Speed limits and single lane and corners you actually have to brake for. That was the old road. hard to imagine that once upon a time these roads carried all the traffic between Sydney and Brisbane. And like that, it switches back to 90 k's an hour. It's a little bit windier than the normal freeway.
Pacific Highway has organically evolved from the Great Northern Highway from Sydney, pushing north, and the South Coast Road from Queensland, snaking its way through dairy and sugar farms and eventually connecting together in what is declared the combined Pacific Highway on the 26th of May 1931.
I do remember when I was young doing that trip, my old 82 Celica, that this was one of the highlights. I couldn't recall until just now where it was, but I remember somewhere between the Gold Coast and Byron Bay there was an amazing bit of road. Here it is, hidden away. Break, sausage roll, back on the road again. The Moo Moo Road stop in Moo Ball. Brunswick Valley Way, another rename. So we're going to go through Brunswick Heads. Here's an example of one of the towns that you would have previously driven through. Restarted. Basically it was cut off, which is why I had to get back on the freeway, but I love these parts that still exist, but they don't. So this is where you would go to Byron Bay. I'm not going to actually go into Byron Bay because it's a bit too much of a detour for this trip. and it wasn't actually a part of the freeway back then anyway for me. Hinterland Way is another renaming. However, I do remember going through here in the 90s that was just a T intersection. Just see the coast off in the distance. There's the tunnel there on the left. But now it bypasses what I thought was one of the prettiest parts of this journey. Mountains. Look at that.
The St. Helena Tunnel was opened in December 18, 2015 and was built to reduce truck noise and pollution due to the steep grades. It's a part of the 17-kilometre Tintinbar to Ewansdale upgrade project, which bypasses Bangalow in 1996.
Now, one of the other things I was hoping for on this trip, somewhere around here, somewhere along this stretch, there's a honey place that I love honey, but we used to stop at this honey place and get some honey. Don't know if it even still exists, but it used to be something I look forward to. You know, it was a milestone along the journey. I'm curious to see if I can find it again. I can't remember where it is, and I've done a bit of a look for it, like a Google search, and haven't found anything, so it may not exist anymore, but one way to find out. Now, that's the old Pacific Highway, and this is the old Pacific Highway. This is a bypass of a bypass. We go back far enough. Probably a nice little, if you're looking for alternative places to stop, even if you do take the main freeway, you know, a little town like this is probably not a bad idea. A nice little coffee shop, and it's not too much of a detour off the main road. Absolutely, this would be a lovely place to stop. Byron Bay that way. We're going to stay on the Hinterland Way. So that's the freeway right there. So yeah, not a bad little detour there, nice and quick. Get off the freeway, have a nice bite to eat.
Bypass is actually relatively recent, only opened in 2011.
interesting detour that I thought, in theory, might have been more of the original road, but I just saw a sign that said the ferry is closed.
Yeah, it is closed. And there was a charge even, wow. Flat sucks. So I was gonna take this section all along here, down through here, which I thought would have been nice, but where can I get back onto that? I'm gonna have to get essentially back on the freeway, get back to it there, Wardell. Back on the freeway, take the exit at Wardell. That'll get us back on track.
Hiding behind the windshield, trying to get rid of this buffer.
See the noise difference?
On 10th of April 1964, the ferry was replaced with this new Warden Bridge. This split the village in half because the Pacific Highway previously ran along the River Drive along the southern bank of the river, with two vehicle ferries operating at Burns Point at Balina.
On the main freeway, there's parts of the freeway that they, I don't remember the term for it, but they essentially upgrade the existing road as opposed to creating a new one alongside it. And so on those occasions, there's no old road as such. So, where does this go though? There is on this one. Just couldn't see it on the map. It's a dead end. Can I sneak back one through here? Don't tell anyone. Adventure! 40 k's on the freeway. Ah well, it is what it is.
The Harwood Bridge was completed in August 1966 and replaced the last ferry crossing on the state highway system in New South Wales. Prior to the opening of the bridge, the river crossing was provided by three cable-guided ferries operating in parallel. That bridge is now effectively bypassed with the Grafton to Balina upgrades, creating a new four-lane, 1.5 kilometre long concrete bridge that sits just 20 metres to the east.
Just filled up at McLean and I was thinking I could get something to eat here, but there's not much here and it's getting late. It's 3 o'clock now, and I really wanted to stay somewhere along the coast, and it's basically 2.5 hours to get back towards the coast after going via Grafton. So that'd be sort of, you know, touching on sunset. And as pretty as that may look, there's not a lot of accommodation options until you get into Coffs Harbour. That's probably another 3 hours. So it's just stretching it a bit thin. So instead, I'm just going to backtrack slightly and go to Yamba. I think what I'll do is start nice and early in the morning and knock out a whole bunch of K's tomorrow.
The 170-year-old Yamba has just over 6,000 people calling it home. But with its primary income being fishing and tourism, it can swell to triple that size. It's off the path, a long way from major cities, and there's not that much here to do. So why would people come here? Well, that's probably why. It's got to be one of the most relaxing places I've ever been. I went for a little stroll around town, and on the banks of the river was lined with Bobs and Marges watching the sunset. Dinner at the Pacific Hotel was your typical club style, but really top quality food, so I'd recommend that. One of the best steaks I've had in a long time. Everything was perfect, ready and prepped for a nice early start. That didn't happen.
What?